Great work, everyone.
Yeah. Now let's see who's really under this mask.
Professor Salazar!
It all makes perfect sense.
It certainly does.
Yep. And Jeff, you led this case, so you should have the honor of telling everyone how we figured it out.
Thanks, Fred. We knew that Sobek was scaring people away from the Egyptian exhibit, but why? Well, the first clue was the second statue we found on the scene.
Exactly.
That could only mean one thing.
Yep, and that is...
Sobek was kidnapping barbers and transforming them into statues to appease the angry corn people of Kathmandu.
Whoa, wait, corn people what?
It all came together when the falcon found the mouse in the storeroom. This revealed that Sobek was clearly trying to stop the wind. All wind, forever!
Maybe I should take over here.
But of course, the real puppet masters were the red leprechauns that haunt my every waking moment.
Okay, that definitely didn't happen.
And so clearly, as anyone can see, Professor Salazar is really Mr. Peterson, my third grade teacher who said that I'd never climb Mount Everest's invisible twin, Mount Flabby McFlunkin. Why won't this Professor Salazar mask come off? Reveal yourself, Mr. Peterson!
Well, I thought we were reading the same things into those clues, but, okay. No, you are really bad at this. Obviously, Salazar knew there was a gold statue in the sarcophagus. She wanted to steal it and finally escape the brutal world of Egyptology, so she used the legend of Sobek to shut down the exhibit.
Wrong!
She used parts from an alligator display to make her costume. The deity Sobek had a crocodile head instead of an alligator, a detail most people wouldn't notice. She removed the gold statue from the tomb and hid it in the Egyptian exhibit. She was going to sneak it out of the museum.
And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it wasn't for you meddling. And in your case, crazy and misguided kids! My plan was perfect. Sobek is even the patron god of robbers!
Ha! Your scholarly research is as shoddy as your attempts at crime. Sobek was a guardian deity.
I don't have to listen to your poorly sourced nonsense. Take me away!
Oh, no, you don't. Take me away, too. I'm going downtown with you to keep explaining how wrong you are in jail.
Well, I feel like that went really well.
Great. I'm glad you had fun.
Yeah. I think I'm going to quit my job at the museum and finally take up mystery solving full time. I've even got my own mystery gang. You kids ready to put an end to the Red Leprechaun conspiracy once and for all?
Yeah!
Come on, the flying catcopter!
Well, gang, you guys did great. I'm sorry I doubted you and myself.
Like, it's okay, Fred. There's no other leader I'd rather try to avoid listening to than you.
For real?
Yeah, Fred. You might say we're all perched on your arm.
And in the end, no matter how crazy it gets, you always have everything under control.